G'day boys and girls, welcome to Sunday School. Today I'm not in a studio at home. I'm actually very close to my house. I'm in Dromara, 2 miles away. And it's Saturday afternoon and we're setting up for a big tent mission. John Weir's coming to do an adult mission for 2 weeks. But just before the adult mission, the hour before it, from 6:30 to 7:15, we're going to be running 4 buses for the children of Canallan and Dromara and surroundings for children to come to the tent for a children's mission. I love children's missions. But last week, I wonder, were you at the fun day we had at Nuts Corner? And we were able to make a video at the fun day. There was 20 bouncy castles, lots of food, a barbecue, so much fun, and good weather was tremendous. It was amazing, so hot and sunny. God was so good and so kind to us, and we were able to record a video just at the bouncy castles. We'll share that in a moment's time. But we're going to sing a song, Light of the World, because I just love it. We're going to insert the video and you sing along. Here we go.
The world is searching for an answer, a ray of hope in a hopeless world. Who can we turn to? Where is our rescue? There is someone, he's the answer.
I really love that song, Light, Light, Light. Who is the light of the world? Of course, it's the Lord Jesus Christ. There's a wee verse I want to leave with you now for a memory verse, and it's found in Psalm 133, verse 1. Behold, how good and pleasant it is when brethren or brothers dwell together in unity. And I love that verse. It's right in the middle of the Bible. It says, whenever you want God to bless you, when there's a team, everyone must work in harmony, they must work in unity, they must work together. You can't have people disagreeing with each other, fighting with each other, and expect God to bless it. Everyone must work in sync together and harmony together for God to bless. At the fun day, everyone was there for the one common purpose, to let the children have fun. Everyone cooking the burgers, everyone preparing food, looking after the bouncy castle. Everyone was there, not for their own ego trip, sacrificed their own time so children could have fun. Likewise, and especially in a mission for children, for them to come and hear the gospel, it's so important that every single worker comes with the right framework of mind, of heart, and of spirit, that they're all together in unity, that for the salvation of the children. Why do we do that? Because the Bible says the souls of the children are precious. Children are just children for such a little time in their lives, and they become teenagers, then they become adults, and adults are so much harder to reach. John Weir is an evangelist all over Northern Ireland, and he reaches adults week in and week out. But for me, we like to reach the rising generation, the children who are alive today, and we invite them to come to a mission. So we're going to repeat that again, if you can. Psalm 133, verse 1. Behold, how good and pleasant it is when brethren dwell together in unity. And that's what the psalmist says. For God to bless, there must be harmony, there must be unity. Whether it's in a football team or a Sunday school or a school or a family, if there's no unity in a family, you can't expect blessing. And nowadays you hear it more and more when there's disunity, when there are people are friction with each other, they're talking about one another. But for God to bless, there must be harmony and there must be unity. And the blessing of God is a wonderful thing. Whenever you do a mission and a child comes up and says, excuse me, can I become a Christian? Or writes in a wee sheet, I would love to be a child of God. Please tell me what I must do. And the Bible talks about the soul winner's joy. So we're going to pray just for Sunday school, then we're going to watch that video. Father, we just thank you for today, for all the boys and girls. And we thank you, Lord, for each one of them watching, for the fun day we've had. And we're in another field, Lord. This time it's different. It's for a mission. And we just think of the word unity. Will you bless families today? Will you bless churches today? And help people to realize it's so important to work together in unity. So, Father, we just thank you for this opportunity. In Jesus' name, amen. Here we go to remind us of the fun day.
I will pray rejoicing from my heart.
Pray rejoicing from my heart.
For in him my victory's lifted high.
His salvation is my cry.
He has overcome my enemy.
Our praises scorn the enemy.
I delight.
To our sons and daughters, God Most High, God our Father, we bear witness.
G'day boys and girls, it's Colin here, and we've just organized a big fun day. I love organizing events, and for the reason being, especially events where children can come and enjoy themselves. And God has been so good and so kind, because we prayed for good weather, a blue sky and dry. Whenever you've got bouncy castles, it's important it's dry weather, because not only that, it's dry for the kids. Their feet's not getting wet. They can bounce and really enjoy themselves. And there's like 20 different bouncy castles here. There's slides and there's bouncy castles and there's a rodeo bull and there's a big tractor and there's all sorts of ones where children can have inflatables where they can have competition together, try and knock each other off. And then there's a barbecue where there's burgers and sausages and chicken. And then there's going to be ice cream. So people, whenever we were in Jamaica, the wee children would often say, me belly hungry man. Then whenever they get their food, they would say, me belly full man. And that was often great satisfaction. We lived in Jamaica for 1 year, whenever you could do something for the children. The motto for our ministry, we often say, it's for the children as unto the Lord. And truly we can say today, God is good all the time, and all the time God is good. And whenever I think about this here, for me, I think about one of my favorite challenging verses in the Bible is the night cometh when no man can work. And that reminds me that while it is day, we have to serve the Lord. And serving the Lord for me is not just going to church, it's not just preaching, it's living out the Christian faith. It's doing something for God to give God the glory for what you do. And lots of people helping. There's over 30 volunteers, all Christians, who've given off their time today to come early, to help organize, to help plan, to help prepare, to help serve the food, to help man and supervise the bouncy castles. This is their way of serving the Lord. Not everyone preaches. Like whenever we think of the Bible verse, whenever Paul preached, somebody Apollos watered, but it was God to give the increase. Salvation is of the Lord. So everything we do, it's all about making an impact in a child's life. It's so important because we've only got one life on this earth, and whatever you do for Christ will last. It's so easy to get caught up with business and with life and with study and with school and putting it off till tomorrow, wanting to do something, planning to do something. But the Bible says, boast not thyself of tomorrow, for thou knowest not what a day may bring forth. Likewise, we're not to worry about tomorrow, because tomorrow will take care of itself. So whenever I get an idea, thought, I pray about it, talk with Joanna, talk with some friends, then we go with it. And we generally work with people who have got the same vision as us, not people who hinder, but wise people. If they see it's not going to work or there's an obstacle, they would talk with us, then would say, well, don't do that. But this has really proven to its work. There's almost 1,000 people here at this fun day, and it's wonderful. It's a big farm. It's a big field. It's safe for children. The sky's blue. We've got a big generator that brings up all the castles. It boils the water, and it keeps a wee van cool, so when the burgers and the ice cream and everything that can be frozen, then given out to the children. So it's a lovely day. And there's another saying, there's a blessing in the doing. Whenever you do something for God, he blesses you in doing that. But if you don't do nothing, you can't be blessed if you don't do. The Lord will honor what you do. But it's like faith. You've got to take a step first, then God honors it. Anything we do, if we're prompted by the Spirit of God at all, we take the step, then God comes with us and honors it. He doesn't hand us a golden spoon and say, there's money, go and do something. We do it, and God brings the money in. Or God says, there's bouncy castles, go and use them. He gives you wisdom, he gives you brains, he gives you discernment, and he gives you vision to do something. And I thought, for me, this isn't really a big task for me to do this over the years. When you know in your heart something will work and God is with you, nothing is impossible with God. If God can move the mountains, what is it for him to allow hundreds of children to play in a big field and bouncy castles? It's really nothing in light of eternity. And what's really touched my heart, many of these children, if not all of them, have come over and said, hello, Colin. Because along life's way, we've made an impact on that child's life, either in their school or in their church. And then they're seeing me, not just a Christian who stands in their church preaching or their school doing a Bible club, but as somebody who likes to do something for the children. So we're trying to plant a seed in children's life. And I often believe the best sermon ever preached is a life lived before God. Children watch, children read you like a book. They observe you and they watch what you do. We're also very conscious, being a Christian, you've got a high standard, and children watch that and they read you, as do their parents, as does everyone. So whenever you decide to follow Jesus and put your life on the line and you take a step of faith to do something for God, people are watching you. But the Lord is no man's debtor. The Lord provides for me. He protects us. And the Lord looks after all these children whenever they come here. Lots of people, they wouldn't take on a risk like this because they might worry. What if? But the Lord says, trust in me. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him and he will direct your paths. Everything I do, we're continually always acknowledging God and everything he does for us. And it's so, so important. And I love doing this here in the name of Jesus. All things work together for good to those that love God, to those who are called according to his purpose. God is good all the time, and all the time God is good. This could have been a wet day, but could have still have worked, but it just put up a bigger marquee and put covers over the bouncy castles. You work with the weather. We worship a God of nature, the God who made the sky and the sun and the moon and the stars, all these things, but he's pleased to move the clouds, give us a blue sky and let the sun shine. So more than anything, we just want to acknowledge God and his goodness and his kindness. And these children are filled with joy. They're just loving life. And we just pray in years to come, whenever these children grow up, they'll have an impact to do something for God. We often tell the children about joy, J-O-Y, J for Jesus, O for others, and Y for you. Always put Jesus first, others second, and yourself last, and God will honor you and bless you. It's natural to be selfish, to put yourself first, second, third, but for me, it's Jesus first, others second, and yourself last. And in the most humbling way, God honors and God blesses humility, because he absolutely hates a prideful heart, but he loves humility. And that's what we want to serve the Lord with gladness, We don't come here with sadness or a long face. We come here with gladness because we want to serve the Lord with gladness in everything we seek to do in His name. So whatever you're doing for God, remember always to do it as unto the Lord, whether it's serving the Lord in church, amongst the children, or even a fun day when children can have fun. And there's a time and a place for everything. And for today, it's a time for Christians in action, doing something for the community, doing something for the children, for families, to encourage the family unit, that they're very, very important and special and blessed in God's eyes. So God bless you today as I go and have a wee go in some of these bouncy castles. So I'm just walking around the feed here. So many slides and so many things to do, but I've come across this axe one, and it's thrown the axe. And an axe could be very, very dangerous. There's some games adults can use to throw a real axe, and you have a target, and you... And that's a very good one. It's very sticky, it's Velcro. And I thought, there's a story, one of the most inspirational characters in the Bible, in the Old Testament, is Elisha. And Elisha was a prophet of God who came after Elijah. And one day he was walking through the forest, and there was a group of young men, and they were building a college. They were chopping down trees and building a building where they could study and learn about God. And one of them was so enthusiastic, he was busy chopping down the trees, that the axe flew off the hatchet and it flew into the River Jordan. And he started to panic, and he said, "Master, I borrowed this here and it's flew into the River Jordan. Metal does not float, it sinks right to the bottom of the river, and it was impossible for him to get it. It was too deep and too far gone, because it went quite a distance." And Elisha said, "Where did it fall?" And he pointed to the river where it was, wherever it fell. And Elisha took down a branch and he threw it into the river exactly where it was. And the Bible says the axe began to float. And he said, "Take it, put it back on, and keep at your work." So the young man was very enthusiastic about chopping down. And in many ways, maybe it was blunt. And for me, it's so important. Whenever you're chopping down wood, it's so important to keep this part sharp. Because if it's blunt, it's going to have no impact. And when you're hitting it, it could fall off, because it's like using a sledgehammer. A sledgehammer doesn't take down a tree. An axe takes down the tree. And you must keep it sharp. In the Christian life, you must be sharp. Because every single day you go out, you don't know who you're going to meet, what opportunity God's going to give you, and you need to be sharp in your mind with Scripture. We often say, in order to be a strong Christian, there's two things, fundamental things that never change. One is reading the Word of God, and the other is praying, talking to God. They go together. You can't really read without praying, and you can't really pray without reading. Best to do them together. Pray over the Word, and as you read, you pray, and God will teach you and strengthen you. Never get to the stage you think you know it all. Even the disciples said, "Lord, teach me how to pray." These were people who walked with God, walked with the Lord Jesus. And I thought, if this Velcro's not sticky, it's not going to stick. It'll just bounce off it. Whenever it's sticky, it works. Likewise, the axe, it needs to be sharp. And Elisha was a man of God. He was in touch with God. He was a prophet of God. And the axe began to float. That was a miracle. Whenever we think about God, we often underestimate the power of God. He's an almighty God. He's an all-powerful God. He's omniscient. He knows everything. He sees everything. And I often say to children, when they try to work out all about God and learn about Him, before you even think, God knows your thoughts. You think about that. Before you even think, God knows your thoughts. And before you were born, He knew all about you. When you're going to be born, how it was all about. He knows your whole life before you. That's why whenever a person becomes a Christian, immediately they're falling to the will of God. Some people make the mistake of going through life trying to find the will of God. But the moment you become a Christian, you're in the will of God. But the danger is you can slip away from that. When you walk through a forest, there's many different paths, but you must stay in the main path that's for you in your walk with God. If you fall out of it, if you go the wrong way, tell God, "What's the right way? Teach me, show me the right way," and He'll do that. So even these games here at the fun day, there's so many things for kids to do and so many lessons we can learn. And the axe, you've got to aim for the target, and everyone's going for the yellow, the very, very center, because that's when you get the target. Wonderful practice. Watch this one. Shot. What a goal!
Nice shot.
Nice shot. Nice shot. Did you enjoy that turn? Whoa, I absolutely loved the day at the Bouncy Castles, and the rodeo bull was a big treat by many people. Lots of people got their faces painted, enjoyed the Bouncy Castles, enjoyed the food, all these things. Now we're going to finish with a song, and I like the song about the lion, and it's about trusting in God. Hear the big roar, and off we go singing. Song to finish with. Thanks so much for watching Sunday School today. For everyone who came to Fun Day, and don't forget, please pray for the mission this week in Drumara. Last week we were in Ballymena. It was a wonderful mission. This week in Drumara in a tent mission, and this week, next week, we are in a hall in Saintfield. So each town, lots of towns and places where children get to hear the gospel, and it's wonderful. And 2 weeks' time then we'll be in Poland, away doing our 79th camp in Poland for the children. Father, we just thank you for Sunday School today. We'll thank you for the families, for the children, and we just pray your blessing upon their lives. In Jesus' name, amen. See you next time. Bye-bye. Yeah, 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 yeah.